Those of you who have never studied Judaism may be unaware of the oral Torah, the unwritten words of law that God spoke about to Moses, in which have since been passed down from generation to generation. Scholars of the oral Torah understand that from the time of Adam until the flood, God's word forbade anyone from eating animal flesh. The book of Genesis tells how people of that period had long lifespans, with Adam himself living 930 years. After the flood, when eating meat became permissible, lifespan shortened considerably, with Abraham, for example, only registering 175 years. To us, such longevity of life seems impossible, but as mankind has moved away from the Word of God, more animal flesh has been eaten, and the average lifespan has settled down at around 70 years. Coincidence? What does your belief system tell you? There is now much scientific activity looking into how lifespan can be extended. Could this be what the oral Torah prophesied when it spoke of the study of life expansion increasing much faster as the revealing of the Messiah approaches? The oral Torah also says that the Messiah will end aging and war, just at the time mankind develops the ability to not only destroy itself, but also to extend life. The Bipolar Winter Trilogy is focused on this endgame. But will the Messiah be the same as the one that has been taught will appear? Can the protagonists of Bipolar Winter prevent military science from destroying the very thing that could be achieved through other means, namely, food as a medicine, gene therapy, and nanotechnology? The SDA Church is one of the wealthiest organizations on Earth and operates the second largest hospital and educational systems in the world, both with plenty of political influence. It likes to draw the attention of the world to its work on health and education as a way to increase its membership. But what it doesn't headline is its nefarious work on life extension and its involvement with Nazis in South America, and its dubious role in such U.S. programs as Project White Coat and Project MKUltra. It's said that Ellen White, prophetess and founder of the Seventh-day Adventists, was instrumental in establishing the original Loma Linda Sanatorium in California. After seeing it in a vision, Loma Linda University, now one of the Seventh-day Adventists' major hubs, is at the forefront of developing technologies for life extension, including disease eradication, anti-aging, and resurrection. Everything in this trailer comes under the microscope in the Bipolar Winter Trilogy, leading any critical thinking person to ask, are the powers behind the throne of the Seventh-day Adventist Church trying to self-fulfill their interpretation of biblical prophecies?
Dare you not read Bipolar?